your mama doesn't grind your own.
Excuse me. You have to address elders properly, okay? Now, this is the right thing to say. Sir, mom will soon join you. Okay? Thank you. Mom! Good day, Mom.
How are you, dear?
I'm good. And you?
I'm all right.
Mom, I hope there's no problem. I was surprised when you called and invited me over.
My son, I invited you over because I want to discuss something very important with you. There's no need pretending that all is well in this family. Besides, there's been so much animosity going on between you and your father recently, and I want this to stop.
With due respect to you, Mom, the problem we have in this house is that, and you know it. I mean, here is a man who takes advantage of people to his own benefit. A man who thinks nothing about other people apart from himself. A man who, as far as he's concerned...
Enough of that nonsense, young man. Do not speak about your father in that manner. Besides, I did not call you here to apportion blame to anybody. I called you here so we could collectively sit down and look for a way forward to solving this problem. I don't ever want to hear you speak negatively about your father again. Do I make myself clear?
But Mom, you understand the cause of the trouble between Dad and I?
Now that we're alone, I think this is the best time for you to tell me what exactly is wrong with you. You know you can talk to me. Just look at yourself. What is this thing that is making you look like this?
It's my aunt's husband.
What about him?
I don't know. It's just he wants to have me in bed.
What?
I don't know what to do, I'm just confused. The pressure is becoming too much.
Is it mad or something? I mean, this is crazy.
The best thing would have been to leave his house, but where do I go? I don't have anywhere to go. I don't know what to do, I'm just confused.
It's okay, Julia. We'll definitely find a way out of this.
But don't you think you should let your aunt know about this?
The fact that her husband wants you in bed.
Rita, this is more complicated than you can ever imagine. You are aware my aunt is married to this man for 7 years without a child. He's threatened to throw her out if I say anything to her.
Oh my God.
You know what I mean? I find myself between the devil and the deep blue sea. Honestly, I've never been this confused in my entire life.
But... this is absolutely madness. I mean, this is crazy.
I don't want to be an object of destruction to my aunt's marriage. That lady has been too nice to me and my mother in the village.
It's okay, Tonya. It's okay.
Rita. Tell me what do I do? What do I do, Lisa?
Okay. Find the real person. You definitely will.
Wow. I feel good. I knew that I was enough. I feel good.
Guess what, Sophie? You cannot imagine how excited I am right now.
I bet it will be. Mm-hmm. I mean, who would be so happy to have such a contract worth 100 million naira? This is a lasting opportunity to ask you. But, the very man that linked you to this contract.
You mean Alhaji Sulemamo?
Yes. What exactly does he want? And because you and I know that men are only generous to ladies when they want something from them in return.
Well, I don't know. The least I'll say is that he probably wants to date me.
And I suppose you think that is the right thing to do?
Of course. He's a man. And a wealthy man at that.
Yeah.
And you know what? I stand a chance to gain a lot from him in the near future.
Guess what? He is contesting in the forthcoming gubernatorial election.
Even you know what that would do for me and this company. I'll just be getting loads and loads of contracts.
Choco.
Come on, girl.
Choco, you never cease to amaze me. So you want to sell your body and soul to a man just because of contracts?
And I imagine you expect me to date the likes of Ray, my brother.
Who has nothing to offer. That is my choice, and I love him.
All right, love girl. Sit down. Oh, come on, sit down, Sophie. I haven't gotten to that.
I made your point clear.
But I will appreciate it if you just allow sinners like us to live our lives. I mean, what I do with my life is my business and not yours.
Really?
Yeah. Well, you said it all. But there's one fact I want you to know. There is much more to life than money. The seed we plant today will determine the fruit we'll reap tomorrow. Chuku, you have to be very careful.
I mean,
good day, ma'am. Good day. The king put it on fire and said he wanted to shoot.
Okay.
Oh, good. And I hope you guys have everything in order.
Yes.
Yes, what?
How many times will I tell you that if you're in this office, you address me officially, Mr. Nabil Kapo?
I'm sorry, madam.
Now, the next time this repeats itself, I will have you penalized. Do you understand that?
Yes, ma'am.
Now get out of my office.
Choco, isn't that guy supposed to be married to your elder sister, Fumi?
So?
Oh my God. Is that the way you refer to your elder sister's husband?
Please, Sophie. This is my office. And I decide the way I run it.
Oh gosh. Choco, you have really gone way out of hand.
Dad wanted me to study business administration in the States, but I chose to study medicine. And then I came back to the country and refused to manage his business. That was it.
Son, I think you're the cause of this problem happening in this family now.
But Mom,
finish, young man! Your father is not angry with you because you did not manage his business. He's angry with you because you deceived him. You made him believe you were studying business management in the United States of America, whilst indeed you were studying medicine. The worst is that you even kept it as a secret from him for 7 years.
Raymond, sit down. Now, tell me, tomorrow you have a son, and he does same to you, how do you feel?
Mom, we all have our destiny to fulfill on earth. and yours and mine does not necessarily have to be the same thing. You have your life to live, and I have mine to live. And nobody can love me more than I love myself. Listen, Mom, I have made up my mind. I mean, why manipulate people to take advantage of them, Mom? Why? Why, Mom? Why?
I couldn't but imagine who could have sent me a card. Thank you very much. I was even more surprised when I opened it and put it in Justin on this.
You see, Betty, you are one person that I appreciate so much in this school. From the very first day I set my eyes on you, I knew that this is the girl.
Thank you.
Yeah. From that point on, I started watching you. And to be honest with you, what I saw in you is what I've never seen in any other girl. I know this may sound too good to believe, but it's the way I feel. And I'm convinced that I'm in love with you.
Oh, come on, Justin. You can't say that. I mean, we hardly know each other.
You see, I know what my feelings are for you. Okay? Ordinarily, I don't jump into relationships. But yours is different.
Speaking of relationship, tell me, what has yours been like? Thank you. Oh, haven't you been in any presently or in the past?
I was in a relationship, but I broke up with the girl I dated because of some personal reasons.
And I suppose you don't want to talk about it. I mean, I'd like to hear it, if you don't mind.
Well, if you must know, I found out she wasn't honest with me. Found out that she was only after my money. And there's one thing I hate in ladies, and that's dishonesty. It really pisses me off.
It's unfortunate she treated you that way, but I like to say that we all have our personalities. Sometimes what appeals to you might not necessarily be appealing to another.
I quite agree with you, Betty. You see, I've decided to put that all behind me and move on with my life. It wasn't easy for me initially, but thank God that today I'm here, smiling.
What I'm saying is for us to look for a way to put an end to this madness before it gets out of hand. We cannot just continue to live like this in this family. Let's sit down and iron things out.
Mom, you know me. I'm not that kind of person. I'm not the kind of person who will give anyone any trouble. Mom, peace will come back to this house if only Dad will give it a chance.
Oh, darling.
What is this fool doing here?
Ola, I invited
I said, what are you doing here?
Ola, I invited him over because I want to talk to him. And besides, this is house.
You shut up, woman. I built this house with my own money, and so it's I who decide who steps in here.
Dear, I just like the way you're taking this matter.
You? Haven't I told you never to set foot in here again?
Well, I've come to see my mother.
Did you hear that, Kate? He says he's here to see you.
But he's your son.
Whose son? I could never be father to a fool.
Who's interested in being your son?
What is the matter with you? You dare not talk to your father that way.
God help you. God help you if I come back here and find you still standing there.
You have to get going.
Don't mind him, Mom. It's just bluffing.
Don't worry. I'll come back to your office tomorrow.
Where is he?
Ola! You put out a gun on your
finish him if I found him here. But the very next time he sets foot in this house again will be his last day on earth. Nonsense.
I was just wondering. I was wondering when this whole thing is going to come to an end.
Nandi, you're not having problems with Joko again, are you?
You know something, Steve? The greatest mistake I've made so far in my life is to remain in this company after marrying Fumi. Can you believe Joko insulting me in the presence of a friend?
But she does that to the rest of us, and not just you alone. Nandi, I mean, you should know that by now.
And who the hell does she think she is anyway?
Nandi, relax. Hold on.
Just because her father made her the director in this place, she now thinks she can rule over men.
Joko Tade is a sports brat any day, anytime, anywhere. Nandi, listen, I strongly suggest you don't take it too personal, okay?
Look, Steve, it's time things changed around here. I mean, we can't just sit down and allow things to continue like this. The fact that we're working in our father's company doesn't in any way make us lesser human beings, for God's sake. She could learn to accord us some respect at least, Steve.
Nandi, listen. I know why you're finding it so difficult to deal with this issue.
It is because you're lying to our elder sister, isn't it?
Oh, no, Steve. No, you got it wrong, Steve. You got it wrong.
So tell me.
Listen. Personally, I feel a man should preserve his dignity and self-respect no matter what.
Personally, that's you. But the rich men's children don't see that way, Nandi. They don't. They feel everything ends here.
Listen, I suggest you take things easy, okay? Just do what you have to do.
You need the job.
I mean, let's face it. We are all going to live here someday.
You know something, Steve?
What?
The person I pity most in all of this is that unfortunate man that will one day want to have that snub, that spoiled brat for a wife.
It will be hell on earth.
Oh yeah, it will be real hell for him, you know. Let's get back to work.
When I found out the guy was cheating on me, I just had to end the relationship. You know, sometimes people are not what they seem. And that's why I'm finding it very difficult to get into another relationship right now. It all turns out that all guys are the same. They are all cheats. They are heartbreakers
now,
and all that.
Come on, Betty. See, Betty, I understand your fears, okay? I understand your worries. But you see, there's something you said earlier that really caught my attention. And that's the fact that human beings have their personalities. I quite appreciate that comment of yours. You see, the fact that your ex-boyfriend treated you badly doesn't mean that the next guy will do the same thing. Come on. You see, it's the theme of the individual. You know, it's about how you perceive things around you. Just think.
The last thing I want right now is to suffer another heartbreak from another guy. It will kill me.
Betty, I'm not going to break your heart, okay? I'm not going to break your heart. Believe me, See, the only thing I want to do right now is to love and cherish you for the rest of my life. And God knows I'm not lying. Betty, I love you. Okay? I love you more than you can ever imagine.
How was your day?
I think so.
Okay.
You stole my axe for me.
Okay, this is exactly what I want, Sonia. I lie now, I can go and fix my hair. Thank you, Sonia. Come back here, Sonia. Jack paid your fees last month, didn't he?
Yes, I think he did.
Are you having problems at school?
No, okay.
The money I gave to you for upkeep, have you exhausted it?
I'm sure you'd be the first person I've talked to if that happened.
Then why are you like this?
I'm sure I don't understand.
For a few days now, Tony, you're scared you're not being yourself. And you know that. Are you pregnant?
Pregnant? No, wrong.
Then tell me, think it I'm making. Tell me, if you are not having the ache that make you a zoo chunky.
Don't lie, Auntie. Back with me. I think my sudden change has to do with the forthcoming exam. There's nothing to worry about, seriously.
Are you sure?
Yes, Auntie.
So keep it now. If you say so, I'll do everything you want. Come back.
Take my wristwatch to school.
Oh, I had to use it. My device.
How many times have I wanted to stay away from everything that I have? How did you walk into my bedroom and take away my wristwatch?
Honestly, Auntie, I have my own problems and I don't intend having one for it.
Rita, come back here. You must be very stupid. Instead of you to be sober.
Instead of you to be for what? My wristwatch. The wristwatch in question. What has it brought with my father's money?
Rita, I can see your growing wings, but you know what? I will cut it for you. Two captains cannot be in the same ship. Don't worry. Let's keep come back. Okay? Because I will not take this anymore from you.
At least now I will have some better space.
Rita! Rita, come back here! Rita! Very soon, we will know the real woman of the house.
All I'm saying is that Raymond is your son, and you can't run away from that fact.
And let me put it to you, that no true son of mine would behave the way Raymond did.
Do you know what Raymond did to me? He lied to me for 7 years. He made me waste my hard-earned money on him.
It is not a waste, Raymond. Raymond is a qualified medical practitioner. And as his parents, we should be proud of it.
I always knew you were a part of Raymond's evil plan to deceive me.
So you knew for 7 years that he was studying medicine, and you refused to tell me?
You'll all suffer for it.
You're getting it all wrong, Jerry. I never knew Raymond was studying medicine in the U.S. Besides, what has happened has happened. Let us look for a way forward to put an end to this problem.
Oh, yes. We'll continue to live like this. As long as that boy had the guts to lie to me for 7 years. He's not worthy to be called a son of mine.
That will provide all your needs, and that person is me. Forget about all these chewing gum boys you see in the campus. They cannot offer you anything. All they can offer you is heart attack. Just accept my offer, then all your troubles are over.
Do you know you're still married to my aunt?
Okay, it doesn't matter. Laraba need not to know anything about this. All we need to do now is to arrange a place where we can meet outside this hall.
I'm sorry to disappoint you, but I have a conscience as a human being.
Tonya, why are you doing this to me? Tonya, I want you to know that I love you. I care for you, Tonya. Please do that.
What's wrong with you? You've been acting all out since this afternoon. What's it? Is it something I've done? Maybe. Is it something? Why are you acting like this? If it's something I've done, please forgive me. I'm sorry, okay? What is it? Please talk to me, please.
Do you really want to know what is wrong with me?
Yes, I want to know, of course.
Your daughter Rita is at it again.
Rita,
Okay. What has she done this time?
Can you imagine Rita coming into her bedroom to take away my wristwatch? And when I asked her, she laid all kinds of abuses on me.
What? Rita did that?
That's not even all to it. She has the guts to tell me that the wristwatch in question was bought with her father's money.
Susan, please. I'm really sorry about this. You will have to find a way to forgive her, please.
I honestly did not expect you to say more than what you've just said. Steve, honestly, I don't know how much longer I'm going to put up with this.
Susan, I promise you, I'm going to talk to Rita like I never did before. And things are going to change.
I hope it turns out that way. Because I am sick and tired of having to live with this. My younger sister is married with two kids. I don't understand why Rita is in the habit of disrespecting me.
Susan, listen. I understand how you feel about this, okay? Please, but I am going to make it work. I am going to fix all this. Please, all I need is time.
I can't recall how many times you've said this. And ultimately, things have not changed. Steve, I think you're part of this problem. You give Rita so much room that she can do anything she likes and get away with it.
Susan, you're blowing the whole thing out of proportion. I have never failed to criticize or scold Rita whenever she does anything wrong.
Then why does things keep happening? What's going on here?
I'm just trying to explain to Tonya a few things you need to know about her course of studies.
Yes, Auntie. Uncle Jack was explaining something that I've been finding very difficult to understand.
Mama, Tonya, is that the reason why you've been downcast all this while?
Yes, Auntie. But I'm very glad that Uncle Jack has been able to explain it to me, and all I need to is just go out and write it, so.
I'm glad you now feel this way.
Sweetheart, thank you so much for everything.
Oh, come on, darling. Do you need to go into all that? Tonya here is like a sister to me. I feel so great each time I'm able to have a sister in any way.
It's okay, then. I just came in to tell Tonya that dinner is served at the dining, and then I meet you.
Okay. Just give us a few minutes to round up, then we will join you.
It's okay.
You see?
You said I'm like a sister to you.
Let me...
That's what you said. How can I be like a sister to you when you're bent on talking me into this evil? When you're bent on taking advantage of me?
Tonya. I want you to know that everything I said to you is from the bottom of my heart.
You're married to my heart.
I know. All we need to do is to give this a chance and they will benefit from it.
You know, when I moved in here 3 years ago and I saw how nice you treated my auntie and myself, you took us out, bought us things and all of that. I actually said to myself, this is a great guy. But I never knew I could be so wrong.
He's still that same guy that is here before you. It's me.
Uncle, please, I don't want to continue with this discussion. I just want to let you know, please.
Yeah,
oh, please.
I'm trying to put on my clothes, you know. Just hold on a second. Hold on.
What took you so long?
My clothes. What's the smell?
I... my new fragrance. Yeah, it's a new product in town.
Do you like it?
So I can go over to your room and, you know, straight over.
Okay, can I get you water? Are you sure you're okay?
Yeah. All right.
How was school today?
Well, splendid. Splendid.
Yeah.
See, we are getting ready for our semester exams. See, if you can see, I've been reading.
That's why I'm here. How are you preparing for your exams?
Mom, fine.
Yeah.
See, I've been reading. See, I went over to read. I had my breakfast. My dinner, came in here, was reading.
That's not convincing enough.
Mom, I'm doing my best.
I hope your best is good enough.
Mom, I've been reading this. See, dictionary. I've been cramming this and it's gonna help. I've been reading all of this.
Jonathan.
Your father wants you to graduate with good grades.
So you can manage his conglomerate. You can't afford to disappoint your father just like your brother did.
Okay, I'll cross that bridge when I get to it. Then, yeah, I will.
Meaning?
Okay, Mom, let me tell you this. The truth of the matter is, I don't even know what I want to do with my life.
Well, I'm sorry. What are you getting here, young man? Your father wants you to...
Mom, see. It mustn't always have to be what Dad wants. All right? I'm old enough to make decisions for my life. I'm old enough to take care of myself. Daddy this, daddy that all the time. What's that?
Don't let your father hear that word from your mouth. That was why your elder brother almost got shot yesterday.
What? What did you just say? Ray?
Yes.
Almost got shot. By whom?
Your father.
Dad wanted to see Ray. Why?
Your brother rebelled against your father. And I hope you are not going to do the same thing.
Mom, I don't like this at all. I don't like it. I suppose you feel that is right in all of this, right?
Nobody's right here. It's high time to set our priorities right in this family. And it's going to begin with you.
You're reading?
Yes, I'm just writing the meantime.
So how is it going with studies?
Great, Dad. As you know, the semester exam is around the corner, so everybody has been busy preparing for it.
Well, yeah. But the most important thing is to be well prepared. Back then in school, students used to dread examination too. Yes, but if one studies hard and is well prepared, there's nothing to fear.
Yeah, you're right.
Work hard, read well, you get good grades.
Of course, I agree with you. There's nothing as good as hard work.
Yes, there's nothing as good as hard work.
Rita.
Yes, Daddy.
Susan complained about something to me a while ago, and I want us to talk about it.
It's okay, Dad.
She said you took her wristwatch from our room, and when she asked you about it, instead of you to explain to her, you talked down on her. Now, Rita, that's a wrong thing to do.
Daddy, I did not talk down on Aunt Susan.
She said you were rude.
I wasn't rude to her. All I did was to take her wristwatch to school. Mine developed a fault last night.
Did you tell her before taking the wristwatch to school?
She was nowhere in sight when I left the house this morning.
Angel, we all know that a human being is an embodiment of imperfection. That is why we are bound to have problems relating to one another once in a while. But the truth is, these problems can be checked. Now, in this situation, a simple explanation would have done the magic.
I tried explaining to her, but she wouldn't listen. She kept on shouting at me as if I did something that nobody has ever done.
Angel, I understand how difficult it is living under this kind of arrangement, but I want you to understand that Susan is my wife. If you talk down on her, you disrespect me.
Dad,
listen, let me finish, please. If Susan does any wrong thing to you, I expect you to wait for me to come. And then you complain to me, and not to talk down on her.
Dad, why are you making it look as if I am the problem here?
No, Angel. I haven't said anything like that. I am only telling you that this is a family, and we should live as one. This is our home. We have no other place to go. We must try as much as possible to make it peaceful, to make it a united home, to make it an ideal home. Angel,
yes, Daddy.
I want you to do something for me.
What is it?
I want you to apologize to Susan.
Anything for you, Daddy.
That's my girl. Okay? Yeah. Thank you. I'll leave you now to continue reading.
All right.
Have this sad look all evening.
I lost a major contract earlier today.
Oh my God. I didn't know. Oh. I'm so sorry. Huh?
The worst part of it.
Yes.
But I lost it to my number one enemy, Patmos.
Well, I know how bad that feels. Really, I do. But you don't have to take it too deeply. God alone knows why things like this happen. Besides, it is not the end of the world.
Yes, you're right. It's not the end of the world. I know sometime again, another opportunity will present itself.
It sure will.
But I wish somebody else had gotten the contract. But what badness of all people?
Well, darling, I really don't know what to say to that. But what amazes me is that after all these years, this bitterness, quarrels, rivalry between you and your one-time best friend, Chief Olabadmos, lingers.
I've told you before, Amanda. Nothing in this world will stop the feud between Badmos and I. Not even if he prostrates before me tomorrow and begs for forgiveness. I will not forgive him.
But we are Christians, and we are enjoined to forgive all the time.
Anything has absolutely nothing to do about this. All I know is that somehow, sometime, somewhere, I will make Badmus pay for all his crimes against me and this family.
Believe it, Gloria. You know, he actually declared his love for me, even though we're meeting for the very first time.
And I suppose you believe him, right?
Well, I don't really know what to believe right now. I mean, after that episode with Frank, I don't think I could get myself to trust in any guy again. Even though that trusting guy sounded so sincere yesterday.
Betty,
what you must know is that sometimes people are not what they seem. And just like Shakespeare once said, that there is no art to find the mind construction on the face. So you have to be careful.
I guess you're right, though, but it's just that I don't know. I'm very, very confused right now.
Give it time.
What?
Take some time out to think about it. Or are you so much in a hurry to accept this proposal?
Maria, I don't think you still like me after this, but it's just that I've already accepted to date me.
You have done what? Betty, was that supposed to be a slip of tongue?
No, Gloria, it's not a slip of tongue. It's not.
Then I would personally recommend you to a psychiatrist because it's obvious you're going crazy. In fact, you are crazy. For goodness sake, how could you have accepted to date a guy you know nothing about? How? Tell me, where is your pride as a woman? Or have you just forgotten suddenly what Frank did to you? Have you?
Gloria, see, I know what I did was wrong, but then... God, I just don't understand.
You don't understand what? Oh, he's good looking, isn't it?
Gloria,
is that what you don't understand?
Gloria, I don't know. I just don't know, okay?
This is a big shame.
Maybe it is. Well, I'm already in.
Oh, just listen to yourself. You're already in. Betty, how could you have done such a thing? How? Oh, you've just forgotten how Frank abandoned you and you were crying betrayer. Oh, he abandoned me and then we're trying to just fix you up. Have you forgotten all that?
Gloria, I know what I did was wrong, but then what do you expect me to do right now? For Christ's sake, I'm already in.
Hey, girls.
Hi, dear.
How are you, darling?
I'm fine, and you?
I'm fine. Hi. So what's up with you, girls?
Nothing really. We're just talking about something.
Okay, that's nice.
By the way, meet my friend Gloria. Gloria, this is Justin. The same guy I spoke to you about.
Pleased to make your acquaintance, Gloria.
The feeling is neutral.
Well, where are you guys off to?
To the library. We just want to pick up some few books for an important assignment.
Okay, that's good. Well, Jesse, I was flirting with the idea of taking you out for them. Probably later on the day. So is that okay with you?
Would that be okay? Sure, of course.
Okay, that's right. So, I'll call you later and tell you where to meet me.
Right.
Okay?
Alright.
Accept right. My call.
I will.
So, Gloria, it was nice meeting you.
I said the feeling is mutual.
Okay. So, my darling, I'll see you.
See you later.
Bye.
Girlfriend, I mean, you've just caught it bad this time around. I mean, you've entangled yourself with the devil himself. I'm so sorry.
And you don't know that after preparing fish, you have your bath?
Madam, no, so you don't say it is time for fish. You know the good mood they keep you the way. Why make me come?
And what are you staring at? Are you staring at my pool? Is that why you want to take a bath?
No, madam.
No, come, let's go. Let's go and take a dive in the pool.
Madam, not that.
Madam, will you get out of here? Let's take a very good look at that pool. Come, take a look at it. Let this be the very last time you will stare at that pool. Do I make myself clear?
Yes, madam.
Get out.
Madam, no, just.
I think it's about time I saw the young man here.
am I even sure she's not even responsible for the key if she knows that?
Don't have anybody in my life. Do it. I'm very sure. That's why I want you.
Okay.
Don't look anywhere. That's why I want you.